Can you imagine being booed mercilessly in front of 200 of your closest family and friends?
My friends and family read the comment section and follow me on Twitter. Does that count?
No.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the?
Not nice! There's a giant head!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Victory Puppies, buddy! High five! High five for the five spot, yeah! It's so good!
Oh, I'm wearing my glasses. I just saw in the thing.
Kings to whom Leafs win 5-0 over the LA Kings. Move over, move it over.
I said that Penguins game, that Penguins win, that convincing Penguins win was the best Leafs game of the season, and that was like a week ago.
Well, move it on over, because this was the Leafs' most dominant win of the season, by far in my eyes.
And to me, it was all the better because it had the potential to get a little leafy. Like the bad kind of leafy. And I'll tell you what all that is in a moment, but first, think you know which way it's gonna go? Make your bet at Sports Interaction. When the puck drops, Sports Interaction has you covered pre-game, live betting on all major sports, and prop bets. Wanna bet? Head to sportsinteraction.com/STPN. That's sportsinteraction.com/STPN. And there's a special prop up right now. And the reason this prop bet is up there is because I thought it would be funny. Prop is, will Nazem Kadri score versus the Maple Leafs on Saturday? Because the Flames come to town, and of course you would think that if you're a pessimist. Prop is available in the description down below. If you're interested, it's 19+. Please play responsibly. Because Kadri's scoring on Saturday would be the leafy thing. And in this game, the Leafs dominated the Kings. Dominated them in the first period. And they didn't have a goal. Oh, there it is. Here's how it's gonna go. People were already tweeting it at me. Here's how it's gonna go. Leafs are gonna dominate the Kings. Kings are gonna go to intermission. They're gonna make some adjustments. And they're gonna score the first goal when the shots are like 20-3, and we're all gonna be very upset when the game eventually goes to overtime and Sean Durzi wins it or something, you know. Sean Durzi from Carl Grundstrom and Trevor Moore. That's how it's gonna go. Except that's not how it went. The Leafs just kind of dominated the Kings from puck drop until final horn. Though the Leafs dominated the Kings in the first period, it wasn't without consequence. The battle of two guys named Nick Waugh and Robertson collide in the corner in the Kings zone, and Robertson gets the worst of it. Waugh is called for interference. Robertson had a real difficult time getting off the ice. After the game, it was announced by Sheldon Keefe that he will miss significant time, and it makes you sick to your stomach for the kid. Nick Robertson has been through so much. His career couldn't have been going smoother up to a certain point. I've said the story so many times, but I need to say it again. He was above a goal a game in over 50 OHL games the season after he was drafted. I went to a Peterborough Petes game March 7th, 2020, and wanting to see a Nick Robertson goal, and I didn't even have to wait until the end of the first. 4 days later in the NBA, Rudy Gobert tests positive for COVID, and they shut the entire NBA season down. The next day, my birthday, one I will never forget, they shut the NHL down, and the Ontario Hockey League would not play another hockey game for over a year. Nick Robertson would join the Leafs in the playoff bubble. He would score the Leafs' last 5-on-5 goal in game 3 of a 5-game series. It was a dark time! He got to play in the AHL under special circumstances and exception because there was no OHL. And he's up and down and up and down between the NHL and the AHL, and the reason for that was he kept getting hurt, including a broken leg. And I'm not a doctor, but dude, I'm not expecting this guy to be back for at least a month. You gotta think when he does get healthy again, they're gonna be like, you know what, you should probably play with the Marlies for a little bit, and they might not even be wrong. Brutal that this guy is hurt, and on top of that, the only blemish on an otherwise near perfect first period, the response, or the lack thereof. Is what Waugh did to Robertson incredibly dirty? I don't think it is. He was called for interference on the play. It was a 2-minute minor for interference. Jeff O'Neill said it pretty good at one of the intermission breaks. It looked like two guys going for a puck. Listen, I don't want any players on my favorite team getting hurt, but in hockey, there is an element of stuff happens. What I didn't like is after the play, instead of, I don't know, getting punched in the head, Waugh was smiling. Now, who's out there? Do I want John Tavares fighting? No. I know some people are like, oh, the captain should fight. The captain had a rather traumatic concussion that was on national television. I don't know if you missed it. Should Mitch Marner be fighting? Well, I think the fans would lose their mind, but no, I don't think he wants to open that door. And I just looked at the replay. I can't make out who the two Leafs defensemen were, but no one! Like, not even a... grab him by the jersey or something! And it's interesting because we head to intermission, we head to the second period, and in the second period is the argument for why you don't do that. Zach Aston-Reese lays out Kaliev, lays him out. Borderline hit, borderline, almost hits him in the head. It's not a penalty. Bob McKenzie had a decent breakdown during the intermission. Listen, you don't want any head contact at all. He gets up, everything's fine, don't worry about it. But the Kings immediately looked upset. They looked like they wanted to say something to Zach Aston-Reese. Like, any response at all. Interestingly, Wah is the one hooking at Zach Aston-Reese, but who comes in and spears Reese pretty much right in the where you're not supposed to do that? 5'9", 170-pound Blake Lizotte. Did Lizotte win that fight? No. But does it have to be about winning the fight or at least the willingness to do it? So he goes to the box, Aston-Reese goes to the box. Interestingly enough, it's the Leafs who end up on the power play out of this. Now the Leafs are on the power play. The second unit's out there. It's Pierre Engvall. Feel the wrath of the giraffe with the drip. Oh, and he scores. You hear that goal horn? Let's go. What a rip from Pierre Engvall, an Austin Matthews impression. And the Leafs, magically after that, on that power play, are up 1-0. What do they score again? David Kiff! Sure! Yeah, exactly the two guys who you expect to score for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Pierre Engvall and David Kampf. And all of a sudden, just like that, the Leafs are up 2. What do you mean, will he score? What do you... Let me see the... What? Wow! Wow! Have they even announced the first one? What's going on? And within the blink of an eye, the Leafs are up 3-0 on home ice, dominating the game where they're up 3-0 on home ice, and it all started with a power play that they got because the Kings decided to fight them. Now the little asterisk you can put on that is Lizotte was called for a slash and not instigating, but come on, we're gonna file that under, it's, I know what he was called for, but we all know what he was actually called for. And that would be the last penalty called on the LA Kings in this game. That was all the Leafs needed. Because later in the period, Mitchell Marner. I said, Mitchell! Mitchell Marner! Interplanetary right now. Comes into the zone and he's got a scoring chance and he rips it wide and the whole, everyone is like, okay, like a small part of you is like, don't blow the 3-0 lead. But most of you is saying, the streak! We need the streak! Mitch Marner has a scoring chance and it doesn't quite go in and all nuts. And then he ends up behind the net with it and he fell down. And Tavares almost scored! And how did he do that? How did he even do that? And it's okay. Now the Kings are going to get the zone exit. They don't! And there's Mitch Marner! And he's all alone! Ah! Rips it past Jonathan Quick, who is having a resurgent NHL season, I think. Am I thinking of someone else? Well, I am thinking of someone else. The save percentage, that's a lot of eights. And I don't think it went up after tonight. Okay, well, that's tough. Mitch Marner mean mugging. Like, can we get the, can we? Yeah, you see? Mean mugging after that goal. He is feeling it. The Leafs are feeling it. And this game is over. Even though we have another period left to play. So beginning of the third period, cooler heads prevail. The Leafs just want to run out the clock. And by that, I mean, Pierre Engvall gets into a tussle with Sean Durzi and slashes him in the back of the head. Durzi goes down in a heap. Now, this was called a 5-minute major. And the thing with 5-minute majors is you're able to review them now. This was maybe the quickest review I've ever seen for anything. But like, whether or not you think Pierre Engvall did this on purpose or he did it with malicious intent, you gotta be responsible for your stick. And the fact of the matter is, in the heat of the moment, during a skirmish, Engvall chopped Durzi in the back of the head. You can't do that. And the fact that it's an accident, I just don't care. And I can't be a hypocrite about this because Gustav Nyquist, back when he was with the Red Wings, he speared, I think it was Jared Spurgeon, in the face with his stick. Now the defense of him was that, well, his stick got caught up and he didn't really mean to do that. Okay, he speared a guy in the face!
So in that case, he was irresponsible with his stick. I didn't care that the net result was an accident. So in this case, even though it's a leaf, he was irresponsible with his stick. Even though it was an accident, the net result is he hit a guy in the head. But now the Leafs got to kill a 5-minute major, and all of a sudden, you're looking up at the clock, and you're like, okay, that's interesting. And we've decided to make an enemy of a guy who has 200 friends and family. He's an Ontario-born player who was drafted by the Leafs and traded by the Leafs. Do we all know the fire that we're playing with? But it's a 4-0 lead. Yeah, I know it's a 4-0 lead. You didn't see earlier this week. Yeah, but that was the Habs. Yeah, I know it was the Habs. They beat the Leafs in the playoffs in very recent memory. I am shaken. So the Leafs head to the penalty kill. And on the penalty kill, oh my goodness gracious. Oh, they got one! It starts with one! Well, you might have been a little bit nervous. I know I was a little pitter-patter nervous, but you want to see the face of a guy who wasn't? That guy, right there, Sheldon Keefe. That's the face of a guy who was not fired a month ago. They review it, it's obviously offside. The goal doesn't count. And for the rest of the game, the highlight for the Kings was Sean Durzi getting mercilessly booed every single time he touched the puck because they never really got close to scoring after that. The Leafs had two highlights for the rest of the game. Number one, Michael Bunting, whatever he was saying from the bench right here, I assume it was all very nice and friendly, and he's just reenacting like the puppets. He's like Mr. Rogers, and he's talking about, you know, everyone is actually loving you. They want to see more of you playing the hockey. What a motor mouth. That dude was a stand-up act on the Leafs bench the entire night. So he had everyone, Zach Aston Reese was laughing. That was entertaining. Also entertaining, Austin Matthews getting yet another goal, and there's another guy who, maybe shouldn't have been written off about a month ago. And to top it all off, Justin Bieber was in the building. And now that I don't edit these videos anymore, producer Drew, can you please Photoshop me into Justin Bieber's outfit for this game? How do I look? Am I rocking it? Are you feeling it? Yeah, you are. Ilya Samsonov secures the shutout. Shout out to the Leafs coaching staff and also the video staff for knowing that was offside right away. Justin Hall even putting his hand up as soon as it happened. And the streak continues. The most important streak. The Mitch Marner streak? Well, that's a very good one. I'm quite fond of it, but no. Oh, the streak in the standings where the Leafs have gotten a point in like how many straight games? I don't even know. No, that's not the streak. A lot of you called this a nothing move. Some people even said he was washed. And I'm here to tell you that the Toronto Maple Leafs have not surrendered a goal since the moment Connor Timmins stepped on the ice for the first time as a Toronto Maple Leaf. Matthews? Bah. Tavares? Meh. Marner? Streak what streak? Connor Timmins is the straw that stirs the drink. What kind of team would draft and then give up on a player like that? Producer Drew? He's speechless, I knew it. Questions. This isn't a question, but it's all that matters from David Alter. Mitch Marner's streak is now as long as The Undertaker's WrestleMania streak.
And on Saturday, we see if the Flames can play the role of Kane!
Get it? Because Flames! Hell in a Cell! I know Kane wasn't the one who broke the streak. It was Brock Lesnar. Spoiler, is that too soon? Not my best. This is a question, but I just want to shout out Alex. Can you do a bit where you get interrupted while announcing the goals, please? Thank you, Alex. That's exactly what I did. From Grant, Justin Bieber, would you like to be on LFR? He for sure has never seen one, and he's not going to see that, but it's cool that you, thank you for sending that. If Marner beats the active player point streak of 25 games, will you and Adam Wilde rock this couple's outfit for a podcast? Also, can you get Justin Bieber on the pod? Stop bothering celebrities who are never gonna come on the show! You know what's amazing? Adam has both those jackets. So yeah, sure, maybe. No question, just Bieber. Alright, producer, everyone's focusing way too much on the outfit. You know, we're not talking enough about the glasses. What are those glasses, Justin? How much Mountain Dew has Mitchell had? You know what's unreal? This is the 16th season of LFR, making a video after every Leafs game. And when I initially read this tweet, I didn't know what you were talking about. And then I realized you were doing a meme because, like, Mitch Marner, he's like a hyper kid. He's a hyper kid, and you give hyper kids sugar, like Mountain Dew, and you give him sugar, and he's hyper. And that's funny. Who came up with that joke? Oh, that's me! Do you know how many times at, like, a book signing or something, someone has come up to me and said something to me, expecting me to understand,
and I didn't understand, and we just sort of stare at each other awkwardly, and then they have to inform me, you said that! And then I have to live with the fact that I ruined their day. Get to think about that on the long drive home from Ottawa. I did a same day drive to Ottawa. Listen, any of you who have ever watched, thank you. Also, 21 gallons to answer your question. So, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. King to whom? Woo!